Morning. It's Friday morning. Day after I started attacking this and came out, fired the chainsaw up, did a little more trimming there and did some wedging. This is actually finally look. Yeah, got it off there. So anyway, not perfect by any means, but this is old sledge wedge, whatever they're called. Broke the handle on it the other day. It's old, really old. So I just need to get me a new handle for that. But I use that as the wedge because my other one got stuck in there. But no big deal, you're right. You just keep going. So I need to get me another wedge. I'm beating my axe up here by doing that. But got that off. All right. Now I just gotta make the decision if I'm gonna rotate that or just keep trimming this edge. Okay. I think the log's just too big to twist around there without doing damage to the sawmill structure. So I'm just gonna clamp it on there and use the chainsaw like my original plan was and just whittle away at it and take my time. I'm trying to see if I can find a faster way. Didn't happen, that's okay though. All right, so I'm gonna unstrap this thing and get the fire chainsaw up and start whittling away at it like I was earlier. And then, give me a pass with the sawmill and then I'll be able to twist it or pick it up, set it down, reposition it and set it back on the sawmill. That may be the process I have to do. Okay, we'll just keep after it, see what happens. Good morning. What is this? This is a Thursday, 17th? No, 27th, something like that. June, almost 4th of July. So anyway, my plan is for the day, finish this. Man, you know, there's those challenges and this log was too big. And if you remember, you know, it'll be in this video, but it was on the edge of a ditch and it was getting ready to fall in and start rotting. But I decided to go ahead and push it over, drag it up here and see if I can get me some 2x8s out of it. And I will, but man, it's been a challenge because it won't fit on there. On that sawmill. So that's what I'm gonna do today. I'm gonna finish trimming it up so that I can get it on the sawmill so the sawmill will pass over it and get me some good cuts. So that is the design for this log. It's been a challenge. I mean, it's challenges because my chainsaw messed up and the other ones were too small to use on it. Then I tried to cut and chisel. And then I broke my wedge and just stuff. My stuff, my wedge and axe and all that stuff was old. So it was due to break. So anyway, stuff like that just puts a stop to the process. So I'm gonna try to get this done today and get this sitting up on that sawmill. Okay, got to get some stuff prepared here and then we'll get some footage of it.
Ah!
boring stuff, so I just wanted to show you a little bit of that. All right, I got that, I don't know, the tip or whatever you want to call it down there cut off. So you can see how it's starting to square off a little bit. Probably gonna have to cut on this right there, that where a branch was coming off. Cut that off a little bit, chisel it down, or not chisel it down, but cut her down. Probably cut this down a little bit more, just a little bit. And then I'm gonna get the backhoe over here and roll this thing that way a little bit and start cutting on this edge right here a little bit, because I need to get that cut down and squared off a little bit right through this edge. So I'll have three kind of flat sides so I can start cutting some lumber off this log. Okay, I'm gonna fire it up and start working on this part right here. So, making progress. Well, I got my bad boy over here. Move this, rotated it over so I can get to that side right there, that top side. I'm gonna just chisel, I'm not gonna chisel, I'm gonna cut. I keep saying chisel, and I have chiseled. When my chainsaw broke, I went ahead and chiseled some areas. Thought that might be easier. No, not. Not easier than a working chainsaw, that's for sure. So anyway, rotated that over. Look at this freaking, what is that? I don't know what that is. Seam right there. Man, here in Oklahoma, there's just no telling what you're gonna see. So anyway, I've already cut some little guides through there, and I'm just gonna go right along the top right there, try to make it as level as I can right through here. Chisel it down. Looks like I'm gonna have to take that tip off a little bit more right there. And then I'm gonna lift it up, put it on there. And if I gotta do any more sizing, it'll be a little easier, hopefully. That's what I'm hoping. We never know. But I think the blade can cut 21 inches. Sorry about all the stuff on my face, but that's what happens when you work. I think it's 21 inches, so I gotta make sure that when I set it on there, you know, that I've got at least a 21 wide area there. So I'll kind of check that, and it could round a little bit, because you know, if I'm cutting the high, you know, at the bottom I won't need as much. But that's what I'm looking at. I'm gonna kind of cut that top off, then I'll have three kind of flat sides. Anyway, so that's what I'm getting ready to do. Okay. All right, I got this all smooth as best I can right now. I think it's to the point where I can run the sawmill over it. We'll find out once I get it on. So getting ready to try to load this on. I'm not sure if this is gonna grab. I may end up having to lift it up and strap it on. But I'm gonna try with my hook right here first, because it's designed for that, but I don't know if it's designed for a log this big as far as being able to grab it. But anyway, all right, so I'm gonna leave this running and see what damage I can do. All right. Well, hopefully that wasn't too boring, but tell you what, you know, when I was on this end moving it with by hand, scary. Need to get me a little strap or something to throw around it so I can kind of be away from it a little bit better. But it's sitting on there. Obviously I'm gonna have to slide it that way to get it over next to the dogs, and or I mean that's the dog, but get it moved over, and I may have to chisel or do some more, a little bit of cutting here and there. But you see, I'm gonna be able to move this over quite a bit. Look over there, that was how far it is away from here. But it's sitting on here, and I'm gonna be able to start milling this dog. Tell you what, this was a challenge right here. See, that's what I mean, I'm gonna have to slide it over that way. What, a good 3 inches maybe? Four or five inches maybe. Get it over there, slide it over, then the tracking will be able to go across. It'll raise up high enough to get past that. And if not, I may have to just, you know, cut down some edges with the saw again. But I dang close to where I want it. This was a project right here. So, okay. You know, this...